Welcome back to my channel. My name is Nandi if you are new. So today's video, we're gonna do something a little differently. So we are gonna be doing some questions that you should ask if you are trying to seriously date. And I did a really fun video on questions and dating with my sisters. I think it was dating do's and don'ts. That was like my favorite. I actually might bring that back, just like a revised one, a new one. But this one is going to be a little more serious. The questions are going to be very deep because we love that. And so if that's something you're interested in, then stick around. Make sure you subscribe and give this video a big like if you like it. And let's go ahead and get right into this video. The first question I have is, are you emotionally available? But also, how do you know? I think when I first started intentionally dating, and what I mean by intentionally dating is dating to marry, I would say that my emotional availability, which is like how willing I am to open up to another person, to be vulnerable to another person, to let someone really come into my space, my emotional availability was probably at like a 90. So it's really important to gauge what someone's emotional availability is, because otherwise it's kind of going to be a little tricky trying to figure that out like along the way. I think that it is something that could be done, but it is going to be a little harder, especially if they are not the type that likes to open up. You know, it's easier to wean out people that are not serious in the beginning. So if this is a square off question, then hell, I am going to ask every single person I meet. The next question is probably one of my favorite questions. And this is something that I got asked. It actually is something I never even really thought about. And that is, how do I add value to your life? And let me just tell y'all, when I got asked this question, I said, shit. You know what? Let me think about that, because I feel like we are so used to, well, me personally, when I get into relationships, I am not really looking at what I can get from the other person. But then I had to shift my mindset to, that is what this is all about. You know, you want someone who is a partner and someone who is a team with you. So if you are not getting anything from this person, like if they are not inspiring you to be better or anything like that, then it's kind of like, then you're kind of wasting your time. I don't want any more relationships that are just for fun. Another great question to ask is, do you communicate your needs? And this is extremely important. One, it gauges how effectively that person can communicate. And two, like I've mentioned before, when you are the type of person who just holds stuff in, you either hold stuff in or you say things that you don't mean, that is not, eventually down the road, you are not going to be fulfilled in that relationship. Because if you feel like you are, one, okay, let me just tell you guys, do not say things that you don't mean, okay? If you want your partner to do something, you need to speak up and ask that. And if your partner can't deliver that to you, then that is something that maybe you need to sit down and reassess. But just to not say anything or have a hard time being able to really express what you actually need down the line, that is not going to make a very communicative relationship. And you are going to have a lot of unmet, unfulfilled expectations because you do not know how to voice what you need. So that one is very important. And speaking of unfulfilled expectations, the next question is, what are your expectations of this relationship? So where do you see us in 2 months? Where do you see us in 6 months? Just what are you actually looking to get out of this relationship? So this is where it's kind of like, to me, this is kind of like a, what are your intentions, without basically coming out and saying, what are your intentions? This is just a different way to phrase that. I think especially in the beginning stages, a lot of people seem to be a little thrown off by the, what are your intentions? And so this is just a better way to just gauge, like, you know, what are your expectations of relationships in general. It may be easier for you to phrase these in more generalistic terms. If you are like me, I am a straight shooter, so I'm just gonna ask you directly. I think this is a little better than just asking, hey, what are your intentions with me? Because maybe they don't know, but if you are dating, you do know what you expect of a relationship, I would hope. Getting into a more serious question, are you dating to marry? This is extremely important for people who are actually dating for a purpose. If you are, like I said, just dating to have fun, dating to just get to know people and have a good time, then this is really not something that you would think about. When I was younger, when I was in college and stuff, I did not think about this. Even in my last relationship, I did not think about any of these questions. Honestly, I'm gonna be real with you. I didn't think about any of this. And this is something that is extremely important, because otherwise, if you are not dating for that commitment piece of things, then to me, that just seems like you're not really thinking long term. You might be going with the flow. Y'all know how I feel about that. Or you might just be wanting to see where things go. And that's cool. But that's not what I'm doing. So, yeah, I think this is also a good wean out question to see who is serious and who is not. The next question I like to ask is, what are some of your personal red flags? So obviously we can ask anybody what their pet peeves are of other people, but when it comes to, okay, so what are your downfalls? This is kind of back to like the, what lessons did you learn from your last relationship? I actually think that's a question, so let me not jump the gun. But this question is basically just a gauge of your own self-awareness and accountability. So what are you doing? You know, what are red flags that you have? Because again, like I said, it's easy to just pick apart other people or pick apart what other people did wrong in the relationship. But once it comes to actually having self-accountability, then a lot of people lack that. So this is a good gauge of how self-aware you are and whether or not you know certain negative traits about yourself. Okay, another great question that I got asked was, how are you wanting to move forward in this relationship? And again, this is kind of like a, what are your expectations? But it was one of those questions that I have never been asked before, that I have never even thought about before. And it really made me think, okay, this is, to me, when I heard that question, I was like, okay, this is a very serious question. And I think right there, my emotional availability went to about an 85. But it was just becoming that much more real. So I was like, oh shit, like it really makes you think like, okay, what am I doing? Like, I think it puts everything to the test that you say you want, especially for me, because I was like, okay, I want a serious relationship. I want to be intentional about dating. I want this and I want that, blah, blah, blah. And then it's like, okay, so how are you wanting to move forward? And then you're like, oh fuck, I got to actually stand in everything that I just said I wanted. And also be able to express and communicate that to the other person and be willing to have them say either one, I'm not cool with that, or two, I want to move faster than that, or anything, you know? And speaking of moving faster, the next question is, what is your relationship pace? And then this is also a question that is easily looked over. We are very casual these days. There is casual sex. There is casual interactions where a lot of things are just casual. I think it's really important to know someone's relationship pace and be willing to express that to the other person and also not compromise on that either. So we have two questions left. The next question is, what will you do differently in this relationship than your last relationship? One of the things that I would like to do differently is I would like to be more of a giver in this next relationship, and not only be a giver, more of a giver, but also communicate things that I need a lot more. I am a straight shooter, but some things I just don't say, and it's not because I can't say them. It's more so just because I like to say, I like to do like the, is it a big deal type of thing. If it is a big deal to me, then I will express it. And if I feel like it's not a big deal, then I won't express it. But then later on, it'll turn into a big deal. So it's like, if I was just to have spoken up before when I felt that, then I could have avoided this entire thing now. So the last question is, what is important to you? And this is a really nice way to phrase basically how interested you are, I guess, in like having a family or like if you're relationship oriented and things like that. So knowing what's important to you, is it family? Is it your values? Is it your job? Is it your friends? You know, just really knowing where things fall in someone's life is extremely important. So those are all the questions that I have for you guys. Let me know if you have any questions that you like to ask to wean out the competition, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.